bit, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of. I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drill, little bit, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. Clothes. Whip around that Batmobile, ducking 5-0. If you step to me, then be prepared for smoke, lil' bro. Let me throw myself a little bit. Let me blow this down a little bit. Drip, little bit, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit.
Today, from CenturyLink Field in Seattle, Washington, it's week 3 of the NFL on EA Sports. We'll see Russell Wilson and the Seattle Seahawks taking on Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys.
We are just about set for football at CenturyLink Field here in Seattle. A few moments ago, they raised the 12th man banner, and this place, as usual, rocking and rolling. These folks love their football in Seattle. This was the scene a moment ago as the home squad came out of the tunnel, and it was just absolutely deafening in this building. They're set for football, so are we, as the Seahawks get set to match up with Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gauden. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
2-1-1 teams here, each looking to move over 500, and we're underway here in week 3. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Russell Wilson leads out the Seattle Seahawks offense. The veteran Wilson, a third-round pick back in 2012.
Whenever you think about the Seattle Seahawks, one of the first things that pops to mind is how well they run the football and how much they like doing it. But you have to also look at how well Russell Wilson has played at the quarterback spot. Hasn't just been a game manager. Last year, over 4,100 yards passing, the second most in his career. 31 touchdown passes, and took care of the ball as well because he threw just 5 interceptions. If you need to open things up, Russell Wilson can get it done.
And he'll get this only up to about the 35. The numbers on the ground for Carson last week. 19 carries, 78 yards.
He's having a nice season, and he knows where he ranks in the league. Don't ever let a running back tell you that they don't know that. They do. So what he's doing now is lobbying the offensive coordinator all week long. Hey, how about a few more touches? He's leading the league.
Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end, complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 12 yards there and a first down. On first down, it's Carson. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I'm here all day.
Mike 55. I don't even know why this team showed up.
On second and 11 now. Wilson. Man, this is a quick slant to Lockett. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 39. 15 yards on the play, first down.
It's always interesting when you get ready for a Seattle Seahawks game, because when you think of their receivers, you think of these guys going to be 6'3", 6'4", 225 pounds out on the perimeter. But Tyler Lockett, he shatters all of those thoughts. Much more like a water bug, but maybe their most trusted target downfield. Led Seattle with 1,057 yards last season, operates in the slot and out.
And now look at this, big gain, but a fumble. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. First look at the Cowboys offense as Dak Prescott gets ready to guide them.
You hear so many discussions about Dak Prescott. Is he one of the top quarterbacks in the league? Is he still ascending? What does he need to do to get there? All I know is that when he's in control of the Dallas offense, they were number one in the league last year in terms of yards per play, and he was second in the league in passing yards with over 4,900. This guy gets it done, and his team really likes him as their leader.
A throw on the quick slant, going to be complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. CeeDee Lamb, 85 yards. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead.
Well, that's how you take advantage of an early turnover. A sudden change situation, meaning ball's turned over. How's both sides going to handle it? One side handled it way better. They went right out on the field and put the ball in the end zone.
One play, that just added insult to injury.
Yeah, that just tells you on the defensive side, they didn't come out ready to go, still reeling from the fact that the ball got turned over.
And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And last time, the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they felt like they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. But fortunately, the ball comes out. It's picked up by the Cowboys.
Can we get some forensics done here? Because I need to figure out.
What, on that ball?
Yeah, on the ball, on the guys carrying the ball. What's going on? Back-to-back drives, back-to-back fumbles. That just doesn't make a whole lot of sense if you're coming out here to play in the NFL.
I don't think the coaching staff thinks it makes a whole lot of sense either.
No, maybe there'll be changes, but if nothing else, there will be a few stern talking to's, that's for sure.
The numbers for Zeke from last week, 17 carries, 99 yards, and a touchdown.
So, partner, you know, two games worth, he's leading the league in rushing, so he's now trending. Is that what they talk about nowadays? You talk about trending? That's what he's doing. He'd like to continue it here in this game.
That one completes, Elliott. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks. A first down throw for Prescott. And there is Amari Cooper, his first catch. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. And they'll employ the jumbo set now on 2nd and 1. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks' 17-yard line.
Well, it's almost as if they didn't leave the field after their first drive. They picked right up where they left off. Another good throw there. And this offense humming here in the early going.
2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's 2nd down. Throwing on 2nd and 8, Prescott. He's going to find Gallup here, complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and they'll be faced with a 3rd and inches. Prescott from the gun on 3rd. Flush to his right. Just what Seattle was.
Okay, y'all, to be honest, the fumbling is so messed up right now. He should not fumble three times in a game. But I just want to say, the Cowboys were awful in the first half today against the Falcons. And they came out of the locker room and they were pumped and hyped, and they ended up getting the W 40-39 with an amazing comeback. They started off that game 0-20. Falcons were at 20, and they made that amazing comeback. But here's the problem. We're going to end this, and I'm going to mess with the sliders a little bit, then we'll get back at it. All right, later.